Hey guys, what's up? So we have already dealt with part 3.1 in which we covered the chapter 1. We are going at a very slow pace so that you can understand. So here we will be dealing with 3.2, chapter 2. Technically it is named nutrition in animals, but we will be dealing with digestion only. So we will be covering obviously everything, but the true term should be digestion. So anyway, moving forward, if you have any doubt or any comment, you can reply below YouTube or on the Facebook page. You know where to go. And please spread the word of this education revolution. Don't just have passive consumption and do spread for others as well. Now, obviously, our focus is always on keywords and summary. So here the keywords are keywords and summary. Okay, so this is what are keywords here. In this slide, these are the keywords. So stop right now if you are watching this and you have not watched before. So just go to 1.1 and then watch 2.1 to 2.5 and then watch 3.1 in science and tech series before moving forward. Because there is considerable overlap and hence I will not be covering the same thing again. So you will be at a very very loss. Baki sab mein to chal jayega lekin science mein nahi chalega. So please watch everything again. Polity mein there is absolutely not much relation between emergency provisions and let's say part 1 of the Indian constitution. But in science everything is correlated. Please don't skip any tutorial and current affairs you have to deal separately. And listen carefully and revise from the PDF of the tutorials. Now moving forward. That nutrition in the animals is covered and you can read all these are the 18 chapters which are present in the class 7th NCERT. We'll be covering nutrition in animals, you can see here. Now nutrition in animals, sir and ma'am, nutrition means nutrient needed, that is obviously we know fat, proteins, carbohydrates, minerals and vitamins. Route and the method of intake, there are innumerable method of intake, you can't even imagine how diverse biology is. It is the most interesting science ever. You can compare it with physics to certain level and its utilization, how it is utilized ultimately. So all three major, that is carbs, that is carbohydrates, proteins and fat, okay, all three of them are complex in general. Don't you have to exclude simple sugars, obviously you can't just have glucon D, usme glucose hota hai aur sucrose jaisi, they are very very simple sugars. So they don't need to be digested. Sucrose mein, when it goes to small intestine, it is digested by sucrase, which converts sucrose into glucose plus fructose. We have already covered it in 3.1 video. What are the carbohydrates? So ab mat puchna ki maltose kya hota hai, galactose kya hota hai, sucrose kya hota hai, fructose kya hota hai, lactose kya hota hai, glucose kya hota hai. So three of them are disaccharide and three of them are monosaccharide. I have already covered in 3.1. And they need to be broken down into simple substance. This process is called as digestion. So digestion is breakdown of complex into simpler substances so they can be absorbed and assimilated. Now most of the non-biology students and non-medicos, they think that these are the same term. They are absolutely different. Absorption means from digestive tract to blood vessels. This process is called as absorption. This is absorption from digestive tract or intestines to blood vessels. Now when it transforms from blood vessels to heart and then it goes from heart to cells after pumping cycle, when it is finally converted in, amino acids are converted into proteins and fats and complex carbs. Like what is stored, how do glucose is stored in human body, how does it stored in liver and muscles? Please find out what is the term. It starts from, everybody must have heard it, but anyway you tell me. So this process is called as assimilation. So when finally it is accumulated inside the cell, it is called as assimilation. There are different modes of taking food like bees and hummingbirds. They suck the nectar out of flowers. Python swallows directly. Aquatic animals filter out. This filtering is very important. Tiny food particles. Infants suckle on the mother's nipple on the breast and drink mother's milk. And there is scraping, siphoning. Anybody know what siphoning means? Basically straw like eating. So there is a thin pipe and then it goes inside the food and this side is the organism. This is siphoning. Sucking, chewing, capturing, swallowing, sponging, so all are methods of feeding. For example, starfish, which is not a fish, it is a non-chordate, which means it is from either of the 10 phylum. So it belongs to the 10th phylum, that is Echinodermata. So obviously you must know these terms, that starfish is not a true fish. Similarly, jellyfish is also not a true fish. Jellyfish is third number phylum. That is Coelenterata. Some people use it C-O-E. I write it C-E. You can see this spelling also of Coelenterata. C-O-E-L-E-N-T-R-A-T-A. Then there is basket fish. Then there is demon fish. There is devil fish. What do you mean by devil fish? So octopus is called as devil fish, and it is also not a fish, it is a mollusk, which is a ninth number phylum. So anyway, moving forward, so you must be knowing these things. Similarly, silverfish is also a mollusk. So anyway, moving forward, so it feeds on mollusks which are like below phylum, evolutionary speaking, then Echinodermata, which are covered by hard shells of calcium carbonate, among others. It eats the organism inside the shell after protruding its stomach out. The stomach comes out of the body and then it is taken back after feeding. So it not only feeds on mollusks, others also, but mainly it feeds on mollusks. Now, digestion in humans is passage of food goes through digestive system, which is a continuous canal which begins from mouth, which technically in human beings is called as oral cavity, but in all the animal kingdom in general is called as buccal cavity, and to anus, which is the last point of digestive tract. Alimentary canal is again technically not in human beings, it is in the other species. In us, we call it GIT, that is gastrointestinal tract, also called as digestive tract. Alimentary canal is for other animals. So it starts with buccal cavity or oral cavity, mouth, goes to esophagus, which is also called as food pipe, stomach is called as food bag, small intestines and large intestine, and anus. Okay, so these are the parting. So digestive juices is secreted by, technically speaking, saliva is also a digestive juice as far as digestion is concerned, because it can digest carbohydrates from ptyalin, and even like elementary level, I'll tell you other things also. So it's secreted by inner lining of stomach, obviously pepsin, HCl, small intestine, large intestine. Do not secrete anything. So salivary gland, stomach and small intestines, okay. And liver is enzymeless secretion, which is bile. Pancreas secrete pancreatic juices, and all of them help in process of digestion. So moving forward, digestive system is associated glands plus digestive tract. So what are associated gland? Here you can call salivary glands plus liver plus pancreas. So these are called as the associated glands. Now ingestion is process of food intake, okay. Now teeth are used in one term only, which is called as mastication. So these are the biological terms. Similarly for urination, we call it micturition. So these are the technical terms. Mastication means biting down, chewing down, everything is included. So breaking down, chewing, biting food into small pieces. They are located in sockets in the gums, and every tooth is different in appearance as well as have varying functions. Okay, I'll tell you what are the teeth. So milk teeth are also called as primary teeth, also called as baby teeth, bolte na bachpan ke daant. Then deciduous teeth is also the same meaning, and it develops during infancy, okay, and it falls off at the age of 6 to 8 years. Sabko pata hai, every one of us has gone through this period. Now dental formula is 2102. 2102 is 1/4 of the dentition, okay. So ek to hota hai upper jaw, which is called as maxilla, and the lower jaw, which is called as mandible. Which of the following is movable? Right now test karke dekh lo. Mandible can move, maxilla is fixed. Only lower jaw can move. So apart from upper, a part of upper jaw, that is half of upper jaw is dental formula, or half of lower jaw is dental formula. So 2102 is the total number of teeth. First number denotes incisor, second number denotes canines, third number denotes premolar, and fourth number denotes molar. These are the four type of human teeth. So in baby there are two incisors, one canine, 0 premolar and 2 molar in 1/4 of the jaw. So total teeth are 5 into 4, that is equals to 20 teeth are there in baby. Now permanent teeth are the second set of teeth which replace milk teeth. The dental formula is 2123. Right now you can count, you will have 2 incisors, you will have 1 canine, you have 2 premolars and 3 molars, okay. So most of adults after 21 year of age have all this formula. Multiply it by 4 after adding all these, so you will get 32. Is that understood? Is that absolutely understood now? 8 into 4 is equals to 32. So 32 daant yahan se aate hain. They usually last through lifetime but may fall off during old age or due to dental disease. So as you can see here, so this is the number 1 teeth, this is number 2 teeth. These are called as incisors. This is called as canine. These two are called as cusps, bicusp, because they are two cusps. They are premolars. And finally these two are molars, and this is also third molar, which we commonly call as wisdom tooth or akal ka daad, okay. It comes at the age of 18 to 21, something like that. Now lower teeth are also exact same replica. So this 1/4, that is 2, 1, 2 and 3, this is called as dental formula. Isse clearly koi nahi samjha sakta is planet pe. So now I hope you have understood it. So this is the, obviously then this becomes central incisor, which is towards center, साइड वाला लेटरल इंसाइजर, देन केनाइन, फर्स्ट मोलर, सेकंड फर्स्ट प्रीमोलर, सेकंड प्रीमोलर, फर्स्ट मोलर, सेकंड मोलर, थर्ड मोलर. जस्ट रिमेंबर थर्ड मोलर इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज विजडम टूथ. नाउ बेबीज में ऑब्वियसली देन दिस विल बी द फॉर्मूला, दीज आर द टू, देन दिस इज वन, देन दे हैव जीरो प्रीमोलर्स एंड अगेन टू. इज दैट अंडरस्टूड? सो नाउ यू विल नेवर मेक अ मिस्टेक. सो मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, इंसाइजर्स आर यूज्ड इन कटिंग, canines are used in tearing. Canines is a term which is also used for lion, tiger. Okay, so they are all canine. Okay, even so they have sharp teeth, that is why they are called as canines. They have pointed edge, these canines. Now premolar teeth is used in crushing and grinding, while molars are mainly used in grinding. Okay, ab aisa nahi ki aap incisor se tear nahi kar sakte, but by and large these are the functions. Premolar is usually used for crushing. Now saliva is 99.5% water. Now I just went into little depth because you should know this. So there are basically five type of NT. These are what is called as immunoglobulins. Okay, so there are five types, GAMED. Just remember this, gamed. Okay, so IgG is the most prevalent, then IgA, then IgM, then IgD, and then IgE. So either you can remember gamde if you want to remember in the exact sequence of its prevalence. This is around 70%, 15%, 5%, 2%, 1%. You don't need to remember that much, but secretory IgA, what it helps in? It helps in prevention of infection. Okay, lysozyme is antibacterial enzyme. Please remember this name, extremely important. It can be and it might be asked in this prelims. Antibacterial enzyme which kills bacteria. Okay, I will not tell you the mechanism how it kills it, but just remember it is present in saliva. That is why a dog licks their wound and all the animals lick their wound using saliva, because it has antibacterial, antibiotic property. टाइलिन इज ओल्डर नाम, अब इसको सलाइवरी अमाइलेज बोलते हैं. दैट डील्स ऑन अमाइलेज, दैट इज स्टार्च जो होता है बेसिकली आपके कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स दैट, एंड सलाइवरी लाइपेज टू सर्टेन एक्सटेंट स्टार्ट डाइजेशन ऑफ फैट. सो इफ यूपीएससी आस्क अ क्वेश्चन, वेयर डज द डाइजेशन ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट स्टार्ट, सो आंसर इज माउथ इटसेल्फ, दैट इज सलाइवा. ओके, सो टेक्निकली सलाइवा ब्रेक्स डाउन स्टार्च इन टू शुगर्स एट सेवंथ क्लास एनसीईआरटी लेवल. दिस इज डन थ्रू टाइलिन और सलाइवरी अमाइलेज. नाउ टूथ डिके क्यों होता है? It is not because of chocolates or sweets, okay? It is not because of them. Just remember, it is written in NCERT, but that's a wrong notion. You can eat as much chocolate and sweets as you want, as long as you maintain oral hygiene. Please remember this term, extremely critical. If you just brush twice a day, buy a brush or datun is better sometimes, and use dental floss. This is critical. 99.9% Indians do not use this. So just remember using dental floss and rinsing after meal. If you do this, you can eat whatever the hell you want to do, nothing will happen to your teeth. But what happens in childhood, which happened to me also, I got my molar out. So chocolate, sweets and any food which is high in sugar, children like me, we usually don't brush and we just sleep over it, and 8 ghante mein bacteria and oral cavity act over left sugars, convert them into harmful acids. Now these acids create hole in our teeth which are called as cavity. This cavity mein now nerves become sensitized, okay? So nerve ke contact mein aa jate hain. Your enamel and dentile are eaten away. Enamel is the hardest substance on planet Earth in animal kingdom. Please remember this. Enamel is the hardest substance in animal kingdom on entire planet Earth. Similarly, in plant world, there is a substance called as sporopollenin. It covers pollen grains. It is the hardest substance in planet plant kingdom on entire Earth. Don't compare it to diamond. Obviously, diamond is the hardest substance. Now there are certain synthetic substances also which are even harder than diamond, but these are the in animal and plant kingdom respectively. Okay, so now moving forward, so this is the entire diagram. Please isko acche se dekh lo. This is the pharynx, that is the first part. These are the parotid, sublingual, submandibular, salivary glands. This is esophagus, and they are the three types of salivary glands. If you can remember, good. If you know, no problem. Jo piche latakta rehta hai muh mein, this portion is called as uvula. This hangs inside your mouth cavity, oral cavity, and this is the tongue. And now moving forward, this is the food pipe, this liver, this reddish structure, this small greenish structure is gallbladder, this is stomach. Obviously now stomach se jaake, the first part is duodenum, the second part is jejunum, and third part is ileum. From ileum the food goes to cecum, and sometimes irritating objects goes to appendix, which is a vestigial organ, just like wisdom tooth. Now from cecum it goes to ascending colon. This, can you see this? Now food will ascend, so it is ascending colon. Now it will go transversely, so it is transverse colon. Now it will descend, so it is descending colon. So technically they are named logically. Now it will go to rectum, where it is stored, and periodic ejection from anus. So this is your entire thing. Now let me emphasize on some things. Okay, so what comes out of liver? So liver ke right or left lobe ko mila ke banti hai hepatic duct. Okay, when it joins cystic duct, that is duct from gallbladder. Cystic duct is duct from gallbladder. Hepatic duct plus cystic duct makes the common bile duct, and common bile duct plus pancreatic duct forms ampulla. I don't want you to say ampulla of water, because for medical science ho jayega, it is not science. But just remember that common bile duct is not inclusive of pancreatic duct. So they all open in the duodenum. Is that understood? So okay, now moving forward. So I'll just tell you in detail. A pass se dekh lo thoda. This is pharynx. These are the salivary glands. This is oral cavity comprising of ovula, tongue, and floor and roof, etc. This is esophagus, that is food pipe, liver, gallbladder, stomach. You will see next diagram. So you can now see. So सबसे पहले food आता है esophagus में, then it moves to stomach, then it moves to duodenum, then it moves to ileum, then it moves to jejunum, and then it moves to ileum, then it goes to cecum, cecum से ascending colon से transverse colon, then descending colon, and then it goes from descending colon to rectum and then to anus. This is the movement of food. So now we will deal with tongue, which is a thick fleshy muscle. Origin is attached to floor of oral cavity. अब मैं उसको frenulum term नहीं use करूँगा, but anyway. It is used for talking, lubrication of food, taste buds are also present. Some portion is occupied by salt, some sweet and some bitter. Three types taste buds are there, depending on person to person. They are not uniform in all the persons. Some person may taste something different, but 90 to 95% of humanity have the same taste buds. Now food pipe is also called as esophagus. That is swallowed food or bolus. Bolus is the term, please remember it. Swallowed food mixed with saliva and bitten into small part is bolus. It passes and pushed downwards towards stomach by muscular contraction of the muscles of esophagus. This movement is peristalsis, extremely critical term, please remember this. Peristalsis is the contraction in entire GIT, gastrointestinal tract. It starts from esophagus and it lasts till rectum and anus. Okay, pura contract karta hai. Now the stomach is a thick walled bag. It is J-shaped technically, but NCERT writes it's shaped flattened U. You can whatever you want. This is obviously the widest portion of GIT because it can store up to 2 liter. Okay. Now entry of bolus from esophagus and exit into small intestine is highly acidic. Obviously there is HCl. pH is 2. Highly acidic. Haath pe lag jaye to jal jaoge. There will be a hole in your hand. That is the level of acid I am talking about. This is called as chyme. Chyme, okay, and alkyl, that is alkaline. Whenever the pH decreases, it's called as chyle. So this is how you remember. If it is L, then it means it is alkaline, while acidic is chyme. So inner lining of stomach secretes mucus, which protects the lining of stomach. Now HCl kills the bacteria and food, and digestive juices breaks protein into simpler substance by pepsin. So remember three things: mucus, acid, and pepsin. Acid is hydrochloric acid. Pepsin is an enzyme which is initially secreted in form of pepsinogen. जब भी ओजन लग जाए ना, इसका मतलब इट इज प्री एंजाइम विच इज ब्रोकन डाउन इन टू पेप्सिन. ओके, पेप्सिन इज द एक्टिव एंजाइम. नाउ स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन इज 3 पार्ट, ड्यूडनम, जेजुनम, इलियम. इट इज 6 meters, दैट इज वाई इट हैज टू बी हाईली कॉइल्ड, बिकॉज ह्यूमन हाइट इज 1.7 to 2 meters, वाइल दिस एंटायर थिंग इज 6 meters. सीक्रेशंस कम फ्रॉम लीवर, पेनक्रियाज एंड इट्स ओन वॉल. इज दैट अंडरस्टूड? ऑब्वियसली. And liver is a dirty brown reddish kind of gland which is present in upper right part of abdomen. It is the largest gland in the body. It secretes bile juice, just remember this, which is crucial in digestion of fats. Fats is bile, bile is fat, fat bile. It is stored in gallbladder and through cystic duct and hepatic duct, which combine together to form common bile duct. It opens in the small intestine. And there is no enzymes in bile. So ye question aata hai UPSC mein, which is the enzymeless secretion. So answer is bile. And bile is used in digestion of fat. And now bile salts is completely different from bile. Is that absolutely understood? Bile salt has nothing to do with bile per se, because bile is digested and in large intestine it is somewhat converted into bile salts. Okay, so I'll teach you that in detail. Now pancreas is large whitish creamish colored gland which is located in intestinal fold. You must have seen its location below the stomach, upper left abdomen. Okay, so this is the location of pancreas. Pancreatic juice converts carbohydrates, fats and protein into simpler forms. Okay, so it is a mixed organ that has both endocrine as well as exocrine portion. Endocrine means which is secreted at targeted location. It is released in blood. Okay, so it is ductless secretion. Okay, jab blood mein kuch cheez release hoti hai that without any duct, so these are called as endocrine organs. Example, thyroid, pituitary, etc. Exocrine means when there is a duct and it secretes exactly a target location. Example, liver, example, pancreas ka exocrine portion. So it is one of the rarest organ, which is mixed organ. Now, last step in digestion happens through pancreatic and intestinal juices, that is PJ and IJ. It is not poor joke, it is pancreatic juices. Carbohydrate is converted into glucose and other simple sugars. Fats is converted into fatty acid and glycerol. Proteins are converted into amino acid. So amino acid is the building block of proteins and henceforth. Now, ab bilkul hi technical detail mein koi pooch hi le to, I thought I should share with this you because it is becoming important these days. It is an area of research. Please focus on the slide. Endocrine portion is just 1 to 2%, which is called as islets of Langerhans. Please remember this term. They are asking this. It secretes glucagon by alpha cells, which increases the level of glucose in blood. Insulin decreases the level of glucose in blood, and amylin is secreted by beta cells. So insulin is secreted by beta cells. Somatostatin is secreted by delta cells. Pancreatic polypeptide is secreted by gamma, and epsilon secretes ghrelin. Okay, so you just remember alpha glucagon and beta insulin. Okay, AGBI. Exocrine is 98% portion secretes digestive enzyme. So protein ke liye protease, whenever there is term ase, it means enzyme. Lipase means lipid ko digest karega. Protease means protein digestion. Okay, similarly amylase means starch digestion. Sucrase means sucrose digestion. Lactase means lactose digestion. Maltase means maltose digestion. Phospholipase, esterase. So are you seeing it, the pattern? Now which protease are there? Trypsinogen and chymotrypsinogen, which will be converted into trypsin and chymotrypsin in their active form. So these are the enzymes which are present in the pancreas secretion. Now absorption is the process of simpler food components entering blood vessels via the intestinal wall. How does it happen? Jo chyme tha, which was acidic, is converted into chyle, that is alkaline, and it is taken by lymphatic vessels. Now what is lymph? I'll tell you sometimes later in circulatory system, and through lymphatic vessels it finally enter blood vessels. This is the process, especially true for fat. Now the fully digested food is no longer acidic, it is termed as chyle and is absorbed in the lymphatics. Okay, this is especially true for fat and proteins and amino acids and glucose or galactose. They can be absorbed through intestine directly. The last step is conversion of disaccharide into monosaccharide, and this happens in intestinal lining. Okay, so there are three disaccharide which you should know, I think. Sucrose, then you have lactose, and then you have maltose. Okay, so I know my handwriting is bad, but it is sucrose. Sucrose is converted into glucose plus fructose. Lactose is converted into glucose plus galactose, and maltose is converted into glucose plus glucose. Okay, glucose plus fructose is called as, this is called as, fructose is also called as, this sucrose is called as invert sugar. Okay, just remember this. Glucose is also called as dextrose. Okay, lactose is also called as milk sugar. Okay, because it is present in milk. And moving forward now, villi are the finger-like projections, outgrowths protruding from the inner walls of the small intestine into the lumen. They are basically, if you see in small intestine, it is like this. It is not, so it increases the surface area like you can't even imagine. So the surface area is about of like huge area, like meter square is converted into huge projections because of these projection. Okay, so there is a term called surface area, you might be knowing. And this helps in absorption. Okay, so villi ka function hota hai, increase in surface area to help the absorption. And as villus folds, so does the blood vessel, and it forms a network. So as soon as absorption happens, it directly passes on to the blood vessels. Now I have told you what is assimilation. Assimilation is nutrients which are supplied to cell ultimately for making the building blocks after being absorbed and transported via the blood vessels. Is that understood? And finally, cellular respiration is glucose combining with oxygen and finally leading to carbon dioxide, water and energy. Is that understood? So this is the cellular respiration. So we'll stop here for today, and do spread the word and be a part of this education revolution. Don't be a passive consumption. At least hit thumbs up and comment below. What happens is it comes on the top of the YouTube list, and then people who are watching crappy content and like which is misguided and facts the galat batate hain kuch log, I have seen many videos, I will not take names, But anyway, just hit thumbs up and comment so that it can come up. And this is the Facebook page of an academy, and this is the my Facebook page, and this is the Twitter handles. And do spread the education for all revolution. And thank you for watching the tutorial. Have an awesome day.